Good morning. It's A Bucket List with Diana Simons and Beefy. And this morning we are very excited to be speaking to the former 3 world title holder. He's had 17 years in the surf, Mr. Mick Fanning. Good morning.
Morning. How are you going?
Oh, we're fantastic. I've got to ask you, how did you actually get into surfing?
It was through my brothers, actually. I'm the youngest of 5 kids.
Being the youngest, you always follow
the older ones around. And my brothers started surfing at a fairly young age, and they dragged me off to the beach when I was about 5.
You grew up on the Gold Coast, didn't you? So, I mean, how can you not grow up surfing on the Goldie anyway? It's perfect.
Yeah, I was actually born in Sydney, and then I moved to Coffs Harbour, and that's when I started surfing. But after a couple of years in Coffs Harbour, we moved back to Sydney, and I didn't surf for a few years before moving up to the Goldie.
Okay. If you hadn't become a professional surfer, what do you think you might have ended up doing?
To be totally honest, my whole world was soccer. I love soccer. And, yeah, it was sort of a bit of fate, actually, how I got into surfing.
I was actually going to soccer sign up, and we actually went on the wrong day, so there was no one there. And then from there, my brother was actually going down to D-Bar, where the contest is at the moment,
to meet up with guys from Quicksilver to get sponsored. And I just went surfing anyway, and they ended up sponsoring us both, which was really cool, and never went back to soccer.
What a story that is.
Do you think, though, that you would have been good enough to go far in soccer as you had done in surfing?
I don't think I would have been, no, but I just loved it so much. I was just so infatuated, as any young kid is.
No, that's quite amazing. The World Surf League Tour events are on right now. There's one, the Quicksilver Pro is right on the Gold Coast, and we've got the, obviously, Bell's Beach coming up at Easter time, and there's Margaret River towards the end of the month. It's a very important time for Australian surfing, April.
Yeah, it's the whole start of the tour. It starts here in Oz. I had some qualifying series events down Newcastle and Manly before this one on the Gold Coast. From the Gold Coast, they go down to Bells Beach, and, you know, if guys can get a good start in these first two events, it sort of sets up the rest of their year.
We've seen the introduction of the artificial surf parks as well. Kelly Slater's Ranch was on the World Surf League Tour last year.
Oh, and I've also got to say, I've been to the one in Cape Town. In South Africa. They've got the wave pool in Sun City.
Oh, yeah. That one's probably not up there with how good Kelly's one is at the moment. I don't know if they'll run an event at the Sun City one, but it's a whole different world. It's almost like a space race at the moment. Everyone's racing for technology and so many cool different wave pools out there. The WSL thought it was a good enough wave to hold an event, and last year they had the first ever World Tour event in a wave pool. So it was exciting, but yeah, really different. So
used to the ocean. Well, that's right, and nearly every wave was the same as well, so you get to try different things, and you can really kind of hone your skills, I guess, is the best way of putting it.
Yeah, definitely. A lot of guys actually, leading up to this year, went over to the surf ranch and were dialing in boards, getting a lot of time on their feet. It's a great training tool as well as a lot of fun.
Yeah, I believe they're going to open one up in Victoria.
Yeah, right by the airport. That's slated to open later this year. Actually, it's not too far away now as well. And I think up in Queensland, one in Yeppoon and on the Gold Coast too.
Why would you open one on the Gold Coast?
Sharks, die sharks.
You can't get enough waves.
Yeah. No sharks.
Don't say that to poor old Mick.
No, it's fine. It's awesome. You know, Australia's got 3 or 4 different technologies that are rumoured to be opening up. The one in Melbourne looks like it'll be the first one open. That'll be exciting.
Oh, I hope you come down and check it out. That would be cool.
Now, Mick, you've officially retired, but the Olympics are beckoning. Surfing is in next year's Olympics in Japan. Are you thinking about a slight comeback so you could be an Olympian?
No. I'm too old and slow for what the guys are doing these days. The level of surfing that's going on at the moment is incredible, and I feel like I'd sort of just be in the way. I just sort of ate a piece of humble pie and went, yeah, you guys do it. If you guys need help, I'll be here to help out.
Yeah, talking about pie, when you did retire, because you would have been so fit, watching what you eat and getting up early in the morning, did you indulge in any slothful behaviour that you had to atone for?
Yeah, look, the first few months I put on some kilos. I stopped training, and if your mate's sitting there and they want to have a counter meal and a beer at lunch, you know, you've got nothing to hold you back. So the first few months was definitely a learning experience, to say the least.
And tell me something, Mick, what do you think makes a good wave?
there's so many different waves in the world, and everyone's got a different take on it. For me, as long as it's got plenty of push, the waves I've had here on the Gold Coast are what I've grown up and just absolutely love, the long point breaks. For me, point breaks are the all-time.
I know you probably don't like talking about it because it happened a long time ago with the shark in Jay Bay, but does it annoy you, you know, that people still remember that, and that they think of Mick Fanning, the guy that escaped the shark?
Look, it doesn't annoy me. Look, I don't really pay too much attention to it, to be really honest. I got over it a long time ago. People just bring it up because it was big news there for a bit. Yeah, look, it's just one of those things. At least they don't know me for doing something stupid.
That's a good point. They know. I was going to say, you actually punched the shark. Were you actually told to do that by your coach if you're ever in that situation, or was that just intuitive?
That is something you never talk about. You just never want to be in that situation. Yeah. And to be really honest, I was just in fight or flight mode. And yeah, luckily for me, I tried to fight.
I know. Lucky, look, we're happy that you came out safely. But, I mean, is there something that you look back at now and you go, oh, that was just so surreal, it doesn't feel like it was actually you?
No, look, I still remember it. I can still see it pretty perfectly in my head. I've had so many close calls in different areas, you know. Sometimes you almost get hit by a car going across the street. So I try and put it in that sort of realm, you know. It's like, okay, it's something that happened, just move on.
Yeah, true. Now, Mick, you've talked about your love of soccer. I know you've toured around the world. Obviously, you've surfed everywhere. But is there a certain event or a certain sports event that you really haven't been to and you want to tick off in your retirement?
There's three that sort of come to mind. You know, obviously the Olympics. I'd love to go and check out the Olympics. I think that's the sporting pinnacle of the universe. I'd love to go and watch Wimbledon. I've been to the Australian Open and the US Open, and they were truly incredible. So different, the feels. So Wimbledon's up there. And then I'd love to go and watch a World Cup final in soccer as well. I think that would just be totally awesome as well. Just the atmosphere would just be next level.
Yeah, international football at that level is just crazy, and the fans just make it an event that you're never, ever going to forget.
Yeah, no, that sounds incredible. I've been to a couple of, like, Euro League games and stuff like that, and they were incredible too. Yeah. Love to just get up to that next level.
Hey, Mick, do you have a favourite beach in the whole world? Is there somewhere that you just loved that was amazing?
Where I live on the Gold Coast is pretty amazing. We got probably 5 of the top 20 waves in the world up here, and it's truly spoilt up here. So if I only had to surf one area for the rest of my life, this would be it.
I could agree with that. And tell me, do you still have to be blonde to be a good surfer?
No, not at all. Not at all.
Very good. Well, Mick, thank you for joining us on this Saturday morning. Glad you could take a little bit of time out of your breakfast to speak with us. And hopefully you will be the next Australian Olympic surfing coach, so you can get to the Olympics and spend some time over there. That would be awesome.
Yeah, look, if I'm not the coach, I'll probably just be on the beach in an armchair with pom-poms going for Australia.
I love it. That's Mick Fanning on the bucket list on SEM+.